G'day my lovely people, welcome yet again to my channel, Eleanor's Chronicles, and of course my name is Eleanor. My lovely people, this is a reaction video on the interview that I just watched on Podcast and Chill with the author of When Love Kills by the name of Melinda Ferguson. This interview was done by Sol Penduga. Let's give the man his flowers because Sol Penduga is brilliant, guys. You know, I it really amazes me how his brain works. And today I saw him in a totally another different light because he delivered us the most powerful interview, or one of the most powerful interview, you know, because the honesty that was in that interview, you know, they went even to the most uncomfortable subjects, and you know what, everything was with respect and everything. I learned so much from that interview. I suggest once you are done here, my lovely people, you go over there, you watch that interview, you come back, we discuss that interview down in the comment section, my lovely people. And maybe from our conversations in the comment section, probably we might get other series, you know, we might turn this into a sequence of reaction videos. So, my lovely people, in that interview, she discussed her book and the controversy that surrounds it. During the interview, she expressed her fear of being targeted over the contents of the book, which delves into the tragic story of Anele and AKA. So, Melinda has faced significant backlash during her release of this book, because I've even seen an interview where AKA's father was doing an interview, I think it was on SABC, where he shot off, called her a parasite, not in so many words, but basically. And she thought that she was opportunistic of her releasing the book when she did, you know, of which even that part Melinda touches on in that interview, whereby she says that was actually sabotaged. I did not release the book then. It was first leaked. It was leaked. It was not me, you know. But then the book, yes, the book is there, you know. But then as to how and when, some things were outside of her control. So she says that, you know, things have gotten so hectic that she's even receiving death threats, whole death threats, my lovely people, over a book. You know, Ferguson is saying that she has received death threats, and there's even conspiracy theories saying that there are NGOs out there and some gangs, you know, paying out in kabi to come after her and boom boom her, you know. And it's totally crazy, you know, the amount of backlash that she says she is receiving. Because I was totally like, what, are you serious? That seriously has been going on, lady, you know. But then to that one, Sol Penduga went in to say, but you've been all over the radio stations being interviewed, whereby you seem to be alluding to be having a list of suspects in the AKA's matter. So it's possible that you've pissed off the wrong crowd, you know, because some of the people who are out there who are being accused of the deed have like 800Ks lying around. You can't be messing with those type of people, you know. So basically what Sol Penduga was saying was that the book might not be where the threats are stemming from. So maybe it's unfair to say she's receiving threats simply because she wrote the book. Because with her going around saying things like she has a list of suspects of people who boom-boomed AKA, then it means the list of suspects is wide, is super wide. We will never know exactly where these threats are coming from. And another thing that they talked about was the issue of privilege, be it pretty privilege or white privilege, you know, because she did allude to have dealt with the subject in the book, whereby she's claiming that AKA was using blacks in order for his career to boom. Then to that, Sol Penduka was like, but isn't that what you are doing, using black stories in order to enrich yourself? And she was like, exactly, that's what I'm saying. So basically, it's like she's creating conversation, saying this are the issues that you're talking about in the privacy of your own home. How about we come out here and we discuss these things out in the open? Then maybe we will not be having issues of racism and whatever, because now we can all come out in the open and talk about exactly what our issues are, of which that is something that we as South Africans are having a serious issue with. We really do not want dialogue. We claim we do, but actually we do not, because we cringe at the sight of truth like nobody. When you hear the truth, it's as if somebody ukthuke enyintamba. It's as if somebody has just swore at your grandmother. South Africans really hate uncomfortable conversations, of which, from what I took from that interview, was that all she was doing with that book, it was not for her to paint AKA in a bad light or make Anele Tembe to look like she was a helpless babe with mental sickness. No, she was just opening a door of dialogue to say, let us talk. There's a serious problem in this nation. You know, we are living in a nation whereby we are glad to just sit back and watch such a beautiful couple being wasted away by substance. And we're gonna say now it's their lives, they got money. The next thing, when they are gone now, we want to blame everything else except the truth. The truth is there was a third force. So now we have an inquest. Of course, there's an inquest because the family needs answers. And those answers they need them in order for them to have closure. But then, can we be able to face the truth that there was a third force there? There was a third force with them there. There was a beast, as she's rightfully calling it. There was a beast in that relationship. It was not just the two of them. That relationship consisted allegedly of Anele, AKA, and the beast. And unfortunately for the both of them, the beast won. That's all she's saying. She's saying, let's talk about it so that it does not happen to our kids and to any of our loved ones. That's all. Please go watch the interview at the podcast and come back. Let's discuss it in the comment section, my lovely people. I really love you.